Yo. Sorry, I'm just getting the bugs out. Is that guy walking a goat? I'm not even kidding. Is that guy walking a goat? Is that a dog or a goat? That's a dog. Damn, that looks like a goat. What up? This is Nameless James, and you're watching Nameless Reacts. Let's go. What is up, you guys? Welcome back to another episode of Nameless Reacts. I'm your host, Nameless James. This is my channel. Subscribe if you haven't. Check me out on Instagram, TikTok, nameless.james. Check me out on Spotify. I got some sick throwback playlists under the same username, Nameless James. Recently was the Super Bowl, and I thought it was a great game. I wanted the Eagles to win. They did not. Sorta, kinda came down to a bad call.
They're gonna say he grabs him, got his left hand on his back. I don't know.
At the end of the game, like a lot of these games do. But all in all, pretty exciting Super Bowl to watch. I was trying to think of a good segue, couldn't think of one. Basically, we are gonna be reacting to the 10 best super commercials of all time. That's right, all time. Every Super Bowl televised. We're reacting to those videos. Strap your freaking boots up, take a seat, grab some popcorn, and get ready, because it's about to go down. By the way, the article here that we're looking at, I just Googled best Super Bowl commercials of all time. I did a little bit of vetting, and this one seemed like they did a little bit of research. So hopefully TVinsider.com ranked these pretty well and didn't leave any out. We are not going to be doing the top 15, though. We're going to be doing the top 10 because I don't deal with top 15s. I don't. Or bust. So here we go. Number 10. Is this Sobe? Number 10, Sobe. Naomi Campbell, Thrillicious Super Bowl. Was that 50, 40? I don't fucking know. I don't know Roman numerals. You know why? Because we don't need them. And we didn't need to learn them in first grade or whenever the fuck we learned them. We don't ever. Anyway, carrying on. Let's see. Okay. You know what's so funny is that this was definitely like peak animation, because this was, I think, 2008, it said in the description, and all these little effects were probably just like their editorial team or special effects team just having like tons of fun. Pretty unnecessary, but this also looks awfully like the Geico Gecko.
Oh, hello.
I wonder how they got away with. Okay. So far, I don't even know what the hell this is about. I have no idea. I also don't remember this at all. I feel like this is a terrible start to the top 10. Like, top 10 ads of all time, Super Bowl ads of all time. I feel like I should know. I've watched every Super Bowl since I've been alive. I feel like I should recognize all top 10, and this one is not ringing a bell, and for a good reason here. Life water.
Delicious.
That shouldn't have been in the top 10. If there wasn't any other options, we should just have a top 9, because that was awful. And you know what? I don't think life water is around anymore. Maybe it was all the money wasted on that Super Bowl commercial. Boom.
Roasted.
Anyway, next video, number 9, Volkswagen The Force. This looks Star Wars-esque. I feel like I kind of remember this. I'm a Star Wars fan as well. Oh, I remember this one a little bit. This is footage of my brother when he was a kid. Oh yeah. He's trying so hard. Fantastic. He's like, did you see that? Wow. Volkswagen, great job. And the little special effect with the lightsaber noise at the end and the logo. Absolutely. That one could be ranked higher on the list, potentially. Definitely better than the last one. That was a good commercial. I remember that one. You're not you when you're hungry, Betty White. I remember this commercial as well. Obviously, Snickers is known for this. You're not you when you're hungry. But I feel like maybe this was the first one. Or maybe this was just one of their... Yeah, maybe this was... I don't know. I can't remember which one they first started with. But let's watch it.
Mike, come on! Mike, what is your deal, man?
Oh, come on, man. You've been riding me all day.
Mike, you're playing like Betty White out there.
That's not what your girlfriend said.
Oh, fucking Betty White! That's why Betty White is a legend. Damn, RIP to Betty White.
No,
when Betty White says she wants a cup of coffee, you get her a cup of coffee.
Man, she was a comedic genius.
Wait, use Snickers. Better?
That hurt.
You're not you when you're
I forgot about the ending. Great commercial. Another great one. Money well spent on that Super Bowl ad. Absolutely well spent. All right, so we got number 7, Britney Spears, Pepsi Now and Then. Not sure what year this was. I'm assuming early 2000s. And here we go.
You hear something new at fountains today. People who think young say, Pepsi, please. The lively
crowd today. Oh, there's a whole jingle.
Those who think young say, Pepsi, please.
Pepsi.
For those who think young.
Come alive.
Ooh.
Come alive.
We're in the Pepsi.
So far, I'm not remembering this ad, but
Pepsi generation.
I like it.
The Pepsi generation.
Classic.
Pepsi pours it on. Pepsi's got that special taste created for the core.
Ooh. Pretty sick transition there, Pepsi.
And Pepsi's got a lot to give.
This commercial had to take all day, maybe days. That's a lot of outfit changes, a lot of scene switches going on here. They had to spend a lot of money on this. Mm-hmm. It's a long commercial.
For those who think young.
For those who think young, that might have ruined the whole fucking thing.
My disappointment is immeasurable.
That was a terrible slogan. For those who think young, it's creepy. What the fuck? You guys nailed it up until then. Oh, God. What are we doing? Okay, well, if I had to rank the 4 that we've watched so far, I would say the Thrillicious one with Naomi Campbell and Lifewater. Get that the fuck out of here.
Get out of here.
The Volkswagen, the Force one, that one's number 1 so far for me. Snickers is a close second. Pepsi would be 3rd. All right, let's do this. McDonald's, Michael Jordan, and Larry Bird play horse. This was 1993.
For your Big Mac, right? First one that misses?
Watches the winner eat lunch. Got it.
Love that sweater.
Off the floor, off the scoreboard, off the bang board, no rim.
Over the second rafter, off the floor, nothing but net.
Love it. So far, I love it.
Off the expressway, over the river, off the billboard.
Chicago, baby! Sears Tower! That one, loved it. Simple. Probably paid out the ass to get Larry and Michael both there, but good commercial. Solid commercial. Money well spent on a Super Bowl ad. Old Spice, I'm on a horse. I already... This classic. This might be like top 3 for me.
Look at your man. Now back to me. Now back at your man. Now back to me. Sadly, he isn't me. But if he stopped using lady-scented body wash and switched to Old Spice...
Also, sorry for whatever the fuck this is. This little thing at the bottom of the... I don't know what that is.
He could smell like he's me. Look down. Back up. Where are you? You're on a boat with the man your man could smell like. What's in your...
The man your man could smell like.
Oyster with 2 tickets to that thing you love. Look again. The tickets are now diamond. Anything is possible when your man smells like Old Spice and not a lady. I'm on a horse.
Oh, and the little whistle. Man, that's such a classic commercial. Classic, money well spent again. I didn't realize that that was a Super Bowl commercial. Super Bowl XLIV, whatever that is in Roman numerals. That one is a classic. That little whistle jingle, I think they went with for years. They might still have it. Money well spent again on an ad. Budweiser, what's up? I don't know when this one came out. I know I was young, but I know this commercial because my cousins used to always say, "What's that? What?" At like family parties and stuff. Let's watch the commercial though, because I kind of forgot how it went.
Hello. Hey, who? What's up? Nothing, B. Just watching the game, having a bud.
Relatable.
Nothing. Watching the game, having a bud.
True. True.
What's up? What's up?
Yo, who's that?
Yo! Yo, pick up the phone.
Hello?
What's that?
What's up? Yeah. Yo, where's Dookie?
Damn. Do you remember back in the day when you could just pick up the other landline and just join a call like that? That shit was crazy. My parents were on the phone with teachers because they were calling home about my behavior. I would listen in, know exactly what they're trying to say, already have my answers prepared when my mom confronted me. God, bring those days back, you know what I mean? Bring landlines back.
You hang up. You.
Don't bring them back. I hated the ringtones, actually. Don't bring them back. I retract my statement.
Yo.
What's that?
What's that?
Hold on. Hello?
The little intercoms.
So what's up, B?
Watching the game, having a bud.
True.
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 Yeah, that one is fantastic. So relatable. I feel like I've done that with my friends. And then just ending it with watching a game, having a bud. Starting and ending it. I mean, shit. I'm sure that did well for them. Budweiser has always been on the money, though. And look at number three. Another Budweiser commercial. Let's see where it ranks.
Bud. Bud. Wines. Bud. Bud. Wines. Bud. Bud. Wines. Bud. Wines.
I do not remember this one.
Bud. Wines. Bud. Wines.
Okay.
Bud. Wines.
Okay. 1995. I don't know how I feel about that one. I don't know. It was kind of funny. I feel like that could get stuck in your head. Like, it'd be hard to forget the Budweiser. I don't know. I don't know where that one ranks. I don't think that was nearly as good as some of the ones we've watched. Definitely not as good as the last one. So let's go with the Mean Joe Green. Mean Joe Green?
Yeah.
You need any help?
Mm-mm.
I just want you to know, I think...
Who? Who let this kid in the tunnel? And is this supposed to be at a Super Bowl? Because especially at a Super Bowl, how the fuck did that kid get in the tunnel? I want answers.
The best ever.
Yeah, sure.
Want my Coke? It's okay, you can have it.
No.
Really, you can have it.
Okay.
Classic.
Makes me feel good. Makes me feel nice
year-round. That's the way it should be. I like to see the whole world smiling with me. Coca-Cola has life.
Okay.
Thanks, Mean Joe.
Smile.
All right, good ad. I know Mean Joe Green was a legend. My dad talked about Mean Joe Green when I was a kid, about football legends. I thought that was great. I thought that evoked some emotion, made me kind of want a cold Coca-Cola. A little slow, but again, that was 1979. It's probably pretty different for advertising back then. So you know what? Money well spent. And the number one best rated Super Bowl commercial of all time, Apple Macintosh 1984. I've seen this commercial, not in a while. I saw it in like a college marketing class, because this was apparently very different for its time as well. Let's give it a watch.
Today we celebrate the first glorious anniversary of the information purification directives. For the first time in all history, a garden of
definitely encapsulating. Word of the day.
Secure from the pests of a contradictory force.
I feel like it's not safe to be running with a jackhammer like that, or whatever the fuck that was. It wasn't a jackhammer, was it? No, it was a sledgehammer. That's what it was. I feel like that is not safe.
We are one people.
Way to go, Apple. Think about how many people just ran with sledgehammers after this.
Our enemies shall talk themselves to death, and we will ferry them with their own confusion.
Is no one like else noticing what's going on? They're in a trance. They're transfixed.
Oh. On January 24th, Apple Computer will introduce Macintosh. And you'll see why 1984 won't be like 1984.
Okay, so I totally forgot how that went. Good commercial. And you know what? Yeah, I mean, to spend that money at the Super Bowl, I wonder what they... I mean, it was... Was it the first edition of the Macintosh? It was the first Apple Macintosh computer. You know, it's pretty exciting. Definitely encapsulating. Again, word of the day. Look it up. I'm going to rank that one pretty high too. Definitely left me curious. Like, damn, I wonder what the rollout was like for the Apple Macintosh. But let's go back and just rank these quickly. We saw a lot of good ones today, but we saw a couple shitty ones. So the top 10, according to TVinsider.com, this Thrillicious one with Naomi Campbell for Lifewater shouldn't even be in it.
Get out of here, man.
I love the Volkswagen, the Force commercial. That was definitely, that one deserved to be top five. The Snickers with Betty White deserved to be top five all time. Pepsi, definitely not. MJ and Larry Bird play horse. That was okay. Budweiser, what's up? That should be top five, maybe top three. Same with Old Spice. Budweiser frogs can get the fuck out of there.
Get out of here, man. Shit, I'm saying.
Mean Joe Green was okay. I think that could be top 10, but maybe ranked higher, or I mean, you know, lower, depending on what way you're looking at it. If you're a glass half full person or a glass half empty person.
Hey, Mikey, go to the bathroom.
And the last one, the Apple Macintosh. I think that deserves to be top 10. Sure, it did really well for them back in 1984. I don't know. I don't think that should be number one. I think that's just giving Apple a little too much credit. So anyway, that was it for this episode of Nameless Reacts. Thank you for sticking with me to react to these top 10 Super Bowl commercials of all time. Drop in the comments what you think I should react to next. Go follow me on TikTok and Instagram at nameless.james. You can follow me on Spotify, Nameless James. I got some throwback playlists, as I mentioned. And definitely subscribe and not miss another episode. Peace out.